Good morning or good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Zane Van Hook over here at DAB Pumps. And today, what we'll be talking about is how to properly prime the Esybox, the 230 volt, and the Esybox Mini 3, the dual voltage. So on the Esybox Mini 3, your inlet is gonna be on the right-hand side, and your discharge is gonna be on the left-hand side. Whereas on the Esybox, if it's vertically installed, your inlet's gonna be here on the front, and your discharge is gonna be over here on the left. Now, if you take a closer look, as many of you know, you can also install these horizontally, where it's properly labeled inlet, so your incoming, and then discharge on your outgoing here on the Esybox Mini 3. Whereas on the Esybox, the 230 volt, it's a very similar setup. Labeled inlet and outlet, as seen there. Now, what we will discuss is also the correct ports to prime on top of the units. I know sometimes it can be quite difficult, but let's take a closer look as to see what's going on up top. On the Esybox, as I've taken this one apart, you will see the priming port located here. Here's your priming plug here. This is your pressure vessel that goes right here. And as you can see, there is an electric bolt there, and we do not want to prime the pump through that port. Now, what that port is the motor shaft to the actual pump itself. That's why we put a thunderbolt there. One, might get electrocuted, but two, it will completely rust out the shaft of the pump itself. So please do not prime the pump or remove that cap unless you've spoken to technical support and they've advised you to check and see if the shaft moves freely. Now, on the Esybox Mini 3, we don't have a lightning bolt. Rather, we have a sticker that says no water, if you guys can see here. It's no water, and the only way to remove this particular bung is by using a flathead screwdriver on the edges here, or if you have a radiator spud wrench, you can install it there. And like I said about the Esybox, very similar to the Esybox Mini 3, the only time that you are to remove that particular bung is when you've spoken to technical support and they've asked you to remove it to check and see if the shaft moves freely. Now, you'll see here a funnel is pictured right above the priming port. So you can either use the tool that comes with the pump or a large flathead screwdriver works as well. Once you unscrew this, you'll fill the pump up until the very, very top, and then you will be good to go. Go ahead and screw it back on. Press the up and down arrow from disabled to enabled, or plug the unit in depending on how you have it set up, and then the pump will immediately start to work. Like I said, this is just a basic overview on how to prime the Esybox Mini 3 and the Esybox itself. If you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to reach out to us. We're here to help you guys. Comment, like, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time over here at DAB Pumps USA. Thanks, guys.